Hey learner, this is Nilesh Borate. In this video we have to see the another concepts of a file handling, that is the formatted file input output, direct input output and the random access to the file. Okay, so first we have to see that the formatted file input output. Okay, so there are the two functions, fprintf and the fscanf. Okay, so this is the similar to the printf scanf, except that this function are used to the file. Okay, so normal use of a printf statement is that the print the message is on output screen, that is your monitor. Okay, so fprintf is that accept the value from separate variable and create one string and pass this string into file by using the separate data type. And what is the use of a normal scanf? Accepting input from keyboard by using the specific data type. So here same, accepting input from file and store it into the variable by using the different data type. Okay, so we have to see the one example. Okay, so going to program mode, so I can open first program file1.c. so in that program I create one file and write the some content into that file. Okay, so here I can use one header file stdio.h, then my main method. Here I can use one declare file star fp, my file pointer. This is my one array. I can open one file, pass the file name aa.txt and open file in write mode. Okay, so I can accept one string from keyboard and enter or write this string into file by using the fputtest function. Fputtest function writing the string into file. Okay, so this is my string and this is my file pointer. So if I can open this file by writing mode, so my file pointer is at the zero position, so this string will be writing from the zero position in that file, and then I can close my file. So see here, I can compile this code and run. So I can pass one message welcome. So I can open here aaa.txt file. So see here, my welcome will be writing into that file. Okay, so if I can run again this file and I can pass the another message hello, so aaa.txt file will be already present in that current directory. Okay, so content will be overwritten. See here, I can open this file hello. Okay, if file is already exist, then new content is overwritten. If file is not available, then new file will be created. This is the use of a w mode in file. Okay, so going to next program, so I can read the content of that file. So I can add some more lines in that file. So hello, then here how are you, so my pin code is 00000, my percentage is 55.66. okay, so here I can open another program, that is the file2.c. so see here, I can use one file pointer, then here I can declare the file name variable and character. So here I can accept one file from keyboard and open this file in read mode because I want to print the content of file in output on my output screen. Okay, so if file is not available, that is file pointer is equal to null, then print here message file not found and exit the program. So this is the predefined function in C, exit. So here I can declare one header file stdlib.h. okay, so this function is defined in this header file stdlib.h header file. Okay, if file is present, then going to next section. So there are, so this is my function feof, file end of file function. So I can use this function in while loop because I can print the whole content of a file till file not going to end. Okay, so here not file end of file, my file pointer. If file pointer is not going to end, then going to for, then here accept the one character from file, and then here the print my character. Again going to next while loop. File pointer can be incremented automatically. Then again check here, file pointer is not going to end. Then again get this character of file pointer and print here my character. So this while loop will be continue till file is not reached to end. Okay, after this while loop I can close this file pointer. Okay, so see here I can compile this code and run. Enter file name aa.txt. So this is my file content. Hello, how are you? My pin code and my percentage is --. Okay. So if I can pass the another file, which is this file is not available, rrr.txt. So see here file not found and program will be exit. Okay. So going to next program, file 3. So in that program, I can give one example of fprintf. Okay. So here I can declare the 3 variable. I equal to 10. Here I can assign one string Pune and this is my floating point number 3.14. Declare one file pointer, opening file in write mode. My file name is www.txt. Okay, so this is my file pointer. I can pass here 3 different format specifier, %d %s %f and istrf, and I can close this file. Okay, so see here I can compile this code and run. Okay, so I can open this file. So this content will be writing in file by using the size of the fixed data type or by using the data type of a variable. Okay, so first variable is integer. So here integer will be writing. Next is my string and next is my floating point variable. So 3 variable here writing. So same file I can read by using my fscanf function. So this is my next program. Okay, so I can open first this program. See here, I can use fscanf function and same file I can open in read mode. I can declare here empty variable and after scanf, so file data is assigned to the this different variable. So I can print here my 3 different variable. So see, I can compile this code and run. So see here, I equal to 10, str equal to Pune, f equal to 3.14. So this is the use of a fprintf and fscanf. So we can discuss the another program, that is the fread and fwrite. So this is my next program, fwrite. So fread and fwrite function are used for writing or reading the content for the binary file. Okay. So here I can declare one array, size will be 5 and there are my 5 numbers. I can open this file in W means write mode. This is fwrite. This is the syntax of fwrite. Pass here the address of A, then size of A. 1 means how many copies will be writing. So 1 copy. And this is my file pointer. Okay. So this content, so this data written into file in binary mode. So see here, I can test this code and I can run. Okay. So I can open this file. So see here, we cannot read the content of that file because file data is written in a binary mode. Okay. So same file I can read by using the fread function. So this is my another program, file 6. So same file qqq.txt, I can open in read mode. This is my blank array. Okay. So by using the fread, the content of file will be copied into this empty array. Okay. And this by using this for loop, I can print my whole numbers. So see here, compile and run. So I can read this file and this is my number. So I can open this file. So you can see that this file we cannot read because the content are written in a binary format, but the data is only understood by the fread function. Okay. So this is the binary mode file. Next, my program. Here I can use the 3 functions. This is the random access to file. Okay, so 3 functions, fseek, rewind and ftel. So ftel function is tell the compiler where is my file pointer. So it return the position of the file pointer. Then by using fseek we can move the file pointer to any position. By using rewind we can reset the file pointer to 0 position. Okay, so these are the 3 functions. By using these 3 functions, we can access or we can move the file pointer to any position. So that's why this topic or my point name is that the random access to file. Okay, so here I can open my file in read mode. By opening this file in read mode, I can print here my where is my file pointer position. So by default file pointer position is the 0. Okay, by using the fseek I can move file pointer in 10 position. So this is the seek set. So I can explain after this program what is the use of a seek set. Okay, so by using the current position, the file pointer will be moved by 10 position, and after moving this position I can print here the file pointer again here. So now ftl will print now file pointer is the 10th position. Again I can use rewind function. After rewinding, file pointer is the reset and it is going to 0 position, and here I can print my file pointer is the 0. Okay, so see here I can compile this code and run. So first my file pointer is 0, after fseek my file pointer is 10, after using rewind my file pointer is the 0. Okay, so going to my slide. So see here, this is my fwrite and fread functions. So use of a fwrite, they write a block of data from memory to binary file. It return the number of elements written. Okay, so this is the syntax. And fread function, it read a block of data from binary file and assign it to a specified memory address. Okay, so these are the two functions for using the binary file. Next, the random access to file. These are the three functions, ftl, rewind and fseek. Ftl used to determine the current location of file pointer. Rewind, reset the file pointer to the beginning. Fseek, we can move the file pointer to any position. So these are the three origins here. The syntax of fseek is that the last parameter is that the int origin. So these are the three seek set. Move the pointer offset from the beginning of the file. From the beginning, this pointer will be moved, and seek cur, move the file pointer from its current position, and move the file pointer from the end of the file. So this is used when the file is opening in the append mode. Okay, so these are the some uses. So if you have the any queries, then type on your query in comment box. Subscribe and like this channel. See you on next video. Thank you.